Very good morning, my dear children. Today we are going to start a new chapter, fraction. We are going to begin the session. Last year after exam, when you get paper, sometimes your mark will be like this, 49 and half. 32 and 3 by 4, 47 and 1 by 4. Like that, you will get marks.
Yes. Huh?
Sometimes may not be 49 or 50.
Ma'am,
along with that, 1 half or 1 by 4, something will be there like that. Huh?
19 by 20.
Sorry?
19,
when we write marks also, yes, 20. 19 by 20, 32 by 40, like that the marks will be written. Now we are going to study like that numbers. Okay, so
ma'am, your video is not clear.
My voice is not clear?
No ma'am, your video is not clear.
No ma'am, your video is very clear.
Yeah, you can hear me. You all can hear me properly.
Yes, ma'am, but you
read. Okay. Okay. When I share screen, it will be okay. Okay. Now, suppose you have a cake piece. Yummy, delicious cake piece. White forest or black forest, whatever you like. You imagine a cake. And your mother cut that cake into 4 equal pieces for your sister or brother, whoever you have, for your sibling, for your father, mother and you. Like that, 4 persons are there. So your mother cut the cake into 4 equal pieces and she gave one piece to you, one piece to your sibling and one piece to your father, and she took one piece. And so, how many pieces you got?
One.
Total, how many pieces were there?
Four.
So, out of 4 equal piece, you got one piece. Isn't that? How you will say that in numbers? One piece out of 4 equal parts.
4 out of 1.
No, one part out of 4 equal parts. So either you can say 1 by 4. I will show you all these things. 1 by 4. Otherwise, 1 fourth. 1 fourth. Like these numbers. This 1 by 4 or 1 fourth. And when you get marks, 49 by 50, 32 by 40. Like that numbers we will call fractions. Okay. And before that, you imagined a cake, a full cake. When the cake is there in front of you without cutting, that cake, what we'll call, it's full, not broken. That cake, like that unbroken object or complete object, we can call whole. What you can call? Whole. W-H-O-L-E. Whole. Unbroken or full object or complete object, we can call whole. And when we cut into equal parts, to mention the number of parts selected and total number of parts, how we will say? If you told, you got one piece out of 4 equal parts. So you got 1 by 4 or 1 fourth. Like these numbers we can call fractions. Otherwise we can say it's a part of a whole. It is a part of a whole. The whole, the cake is a, when before break it, before cutting it, it was a whole. From that, when you took one a part, it is a fraction. So part of a whole. Fraction is a part of a whole. Okay. I'll share the screen. Now, you can see a cake over here. Can you all?
Excuse me, ma'am. I didn't understand what you said.
Yes, I'm going to explain that. Please listen. Okay. So, dear children, can you all see the cake? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. This one is not broken into any pieces or not cut into any pieces. So, this is a complete object. So, for like that object, not only cake, if it is a chocolate, if it is not broken or if it is not cut into pieces, we can say whole. What you can say?
Whole.
Unbroken piece of objects, shape or number is called a whole or a complete object. Complete object we can call whole. Okay, before cutting, have you understood that? Here the cake is a whole because it's not cut into pieces. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
If it is a chocolate, see, it is not cut into any pieces. So it's a whole. Clear? Is that clear?
Yes.
Now, see, here the cake is cut into how many parts? How many
two.
Parts?
Two
equal parts. Not simply parts, two equal parts.
Parts.
Here, total, how many pieces are there?
Two
pieces are there. So, for this piece, this is only one piece. If now I shaded that piece to represent this piece, here, how many pieces we selected? Or how many pieces we took?
One
piece I am going to eat. That's why I shaded that. So this piece I am going to eat. So how many pieces I selected?
One
piece. And total, how many pieces are there?
Two
equal pieces are there. From that one I took. Like that, this piece also, two equal parts are there. From that one I took. So here each part is 1/2. This each piece we can call 1/2 because total two pieces are there. In that, this piece is one, this piece is one. So to represent each piece, we can write 1/2. This 1/2 we can call half, a half or 1/2. Okay. We can call 1/2. 1/2 we can call.
I'm writing like that or in the, when you're saying something also we can say like that.
Sorry?
Ma'am? You say now that 1/2. That we can use it in a sentence. We can put that 1/2 in a sentence.
No, 1/2 in words we will write as 1/2. Okay, we can read this as 1/2, but in words, if you are writing, you have to write 1/2. Okay.
Yeah, ma'am.
Like that.
1/2 2.
Sorry.
1/2 2.
Not 1/2 2. 1/2. For 1/2 in words, when we are writing 1/2. This one you can read as 1/2. This number you can read as 1/2. But when you are writing 1/2, when you are in words, if you are writing, you have to write 1/2.
So, ma'am, so 3/4 is there?
That I'm going to say that. I will show you today itself that examples. Okay. Please. So, like that number is called fraction. Or in this 1/2, this one piece is the part of a whole cake. So a fraction is a part of a whole. Here in this cake, suppose this is a cake, we cut into two equal pieces. This each piece is the part of the whole cake. Isn't it? Each piece of this cake is the part of the whole cake. Am I correct?
Yes.
To represent that, we will write one piece out of two equal parts. One piece out of two equal parts. So, fraction means it's a part of a whole. What is whole? Unbroken or complete object. Unbroken or complete object is called whole. A fraction means it's a part of a whole. So when we write 1/2 like this. Yes.
Then you see some disturbance are coming.
I'll mute all. Okay. So when we write 1/2 like this, 1 is the numerator. The number written on the top we will call numerator. And this line we can call division bar. Or fraction bar we can say. Division bar or fraction bar. And the number written down to this division bar is called denominator. Denominator. So, denominator. Denominator. So, when we write a fraction, the number written on the top we can call numerator. NUMERATOR. RATOR. Numerator. When we the number written down to the division bar, we can call denominator. 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 And the line in between the number, this one, we can call division bar. So that is the form of a fraction. One numerator will be there and a denominator will be there. Numerator will be written on the top of the division bar and the denominator will be down to the division bar. And this numerator represents the number of parts selected. When you write the fraction for this cake, here one piece is selected. So numerator represents the number of pieces or number of parts selected. And the denominator represents the whole is divided into how many equal parts. Here cake is the whole thing. It is divided into two equal parts. That's why it is written 2. So numerator, the number of parts selected. Denominator, total number of parts. The whole is divided. Now, you can see here the cake piece is divided into how many parts?
4 parts.
4 equal parts. 4 equal parts. So
4 equal parts.
Each piece, how we can represent?
1/4.
One out of four equal parts. Or 1/4. 1 is the part we are selecting. And total part is 4. The cake is divided into 4 equal parts. So, 1/4. This one we can write as invert as 1/4. How you'll write? 1/4. Here also. So, each part is 1/4. The whole cake is divided into 4 equal parts. So, each part we can call one part we can call 1/4 or 1/4. Here, I'm going to take from this, I am going to take 3 pieces. 1, 2, 3 pieces I am going to take. So that to know that I'm going to shade them. So these many pieces I am going to take. How I will represent this fraction? So total four pieces are there. From that, I'm going to eat three pieces. How you'll write that fraction? How many pieces we have selected or we have taken?
Four by three.
Think and answer. How many pieces I'm going to eat?
Three.
How many pieces are there total?
Four.
So 3 by 4. Here 3 is the numerator. Okay. And 4 is the denominator. We can read this as 3 by 4 or 3/4 denominator. Here 3 is the number of pieces I am going to eat. So 3 is the number of parts selected. And 4 is the total number of parts or total number of equal parts. Here total 4 equal parts are there. That 3 parts I ate or I took. The number of parts we selected we can write as numerator. The total number of part the whole is divided we can write as denominator. So 3 by 4 parts I ate. We can read this as 3 by 4. If you are writing in words, we can write as 3/4. 3/4. I'll show you like that. Now,
ma'am, excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
So in that cake, if you take 2 pieces, then what will happen?
2/4. If we are not eating 2 piece, or if we are only taking 2 piece, how we will write the fraction? That is your question?
Yes, ma'am, that is it.
Then how many parts we selected? How many parts we selected?
2.
That will be the numerator. Total how many parts are there?
4.
2 by 4. If you are writing in words, you can write 2/4. Here 2 is the 2 what we can call?
Numerator.
And 4 is the? 4 is the? Denominator. Okay.
Denominator.
2 is the numerator. 4 is the denominator.
Ma'am.
Like that. Here.
Division. Division bar you said, right?
Yes.
In that bar means what?
Bar means a line. If you are writing 3 bar, 2 bar, like that bar. A line. Okay. So here 1 by 3. Here the whole cake is divided into how many parts? 1, 2, 3.
Three equal parts.
Oh, very good. 3 equal parts. So each part, how we can represent? Each part. How we can represent? Here, this part, how we'll represent? One part out of three equal parts. So here 1 is the numerator, 3 is the denominator. Numerator means number of parts. Numerator means the number of parts selected or taken. Denominator means the total number of parts the whole is divided into. Okay. From now, here, from that 3 equal parts, we selected or we took 2 parts. So how we will represent total? How many parts we selected? 2. How many parts we selected?
2.
Total how many parts were there?
3.
So 2 by 3.
2 by 3.
2/3.
in words if you are writing, we can write
two.
Here, which is the numerator?
Two.
Two is the numerator. What is the denominator?
Three is the denominator.
Okay. Now,
I join now only.
Yes, we are going to revise the things today we discussed. So, first we discussed about whole. What is whole?
Uncutted object.
Very good.
Object.
Yes. Or full object. Full object. Unbroken or complete object is called object or shape or number. We can call
whole.
What is a fraction? A part of a whole.
A part of a thing.
From the whole, we are going to take a part. From the whole, we are going to take a part. So part of a whole we can call fraction. Otherwise, you can call the numbers of the form numerator by denominator. Numerator by denominator we can call fraction. The numbers of the form numerator by denominator. Okay. If we write a number of the form numerator by denominator, what numerator gives? What numerator tells?
The portion we selected.
Sorry?
The portion we
selected. The portion is the object.
I didn't get.
The portion is the object. Wait. I'll mute.
Those who know, please raise your hand. Yes. Pranav Prarthana, do you know? Anybody? Yes, Mayasa. Unmute and say.
Ma'am, I didn't get your question. Your voice is breaking.
Numerator means what?
Ma'am, numerator means that we have selected that much piece.
Very good, very good. The number of parts selected. Very good, Mayasa. The number of parts selected. Numerator means the number of parts selected. Then what is mean by denominator? Denominator, what you will write?
Denominator says that that there is that much pieces.
Total number of parts. Okay. Yes. Total number of parts, the whole is divided. So, numerator means the number of parts selected. Denominator means the total number of parts, the whole is divided. Okay. Then, when you write fraction, the number written on the top of the division bar, what do you call? Top of the division bar?
Numerator.
Down to the division bar, what do you call?
Denominator.
Practice
for a few questions. Okay. Now, here you can see a few pictures. Aditya, please unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
Here, total, how many pieces are there? This circle is divided into how many pieces?
Three.
Total three pieces only you can see? Total number of pieces?
Five.
One, two, three, four, five. In that, how many pieces shaded? How many pieces shaded?
Two.
So, if you want to write the fraction of the shaded, here we want to write the fraction of the shaded part. So, what will be the fraction of the shaded part? How many?
2/5.
Very good. Because two parts here shaded. So, 2 is the numerator. Then, how many parts are there total?
Five.
So, 2/5. Very good. Aditya, you can mute your audio. Vedika, please unmute.
Thank you.
Vedika?
Ma'am?
In this, which is the numerator in 2/5? What is the numerator? 2 or 5? Which is the numerator?
2.
And which is the denominator?
5.
Very good. Denominator. Okay. Very good. You can mute your audio.
Thank
now. Next question to Ameya. Please unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
Here, total, how many parts are there?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1 minute, ma'am. Can I count?
If you want, I will help you to count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Ma'am, 10.
Now, so total, how many parts are there?
10.
10. In that, how many shaded?
2.
2 shaded. So how we will write the fraction?
2 by 10.
Yes, 2 by 10. Very good. Very good, Amaya. You can mute your audio. Adidev, please unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
Here, which is the numerator?
2.
2. 2 is the numerator. And what is the denominator?
10.
10 is the denominator. Okay. Now, very good. You can mute your audio. Next to Vaishnav, please unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
Here, how many pieces are there? Total number of pieces or total number of parts?
9.
9 parts are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In that, how many shaded?
3.
3 shaded. So how you will write the fraction? Sorry?
3.
3 by 9. Very good. You can mute your audio, my dear. Now, UN, please unmute.
Ma'am.
Here, which is the numerator?
3.
3 is the numerator. And which is the denominator?
9.
9 is the denominator. Now, have you all got, very good dear, have you all got an idea about fraction?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, in fraction, we have discussed about whole. What is a whole?
Whole is the unbroken.
Achyut, please unmute and say, what is a whole?
Ma'am, I was not there in the starting of the class.
Okay, okay. Now, who else? Who can? Yes, Pranav Prarthana, unmute and say. Say.
Unbroken piece of object.
A complete or full object or unbroken object or shape or thing, we can say whole. And Azad, what is a fraction? Please unmute and say, what is a fraction? I will help you. Just try to say.
Ma'am, a piece of an full object.
Sorry?
A fraction of an object.
Part of a whole. Not full object, you can say whole. Okay, very good. Very good. Part of a whole we can call fraction. Otherwise, you can say numbers of the form numerator by denominator. Numbers of the form numerator by denominator.
Denominator.
What is mean by numerator? The number of parts selected. Numerator means? The number of parts?
Number of parts selected.
Selected. Denominator means? Denominator means? What you will write as denominator? Joy. Listen. Denominator means total number of parts. Denominator means total number of parts. Okay. Now, next class, we will do few questions from the workbook. I will send these notes. Please revise all these things for the next class. Okay? Thank you, my dear friend. Bye. See you next week. Bye.